We are beginning tonight with police and social media.
Salinas police, in fact, say that sometimes the best hope they have in solving crimes and the toughest thing to get people to do is to talk. So now they're trying to reach out and connect with more people. Action News reporter Stephanie Truong with more on how tonight, live from our Salinas newsroom. Stephanie?
Dan, the question is, who doesn't have a Facebook page? The answer is we constantly are on it at home, at school, and sometimes at work. And the Salinas police are trying to use that to their advantage. Take a look at their own Facebook page. With it, they're hoping to reach out to people and build trust with the community. Twitter, MySpace, Facebook. This is where you find everybody these days, even Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth as of Monday. The goal, to connect with people, with each other. And that's what the Salinas police are also shooting for.
We're trying to mix the old school law enforcement with some of the new school environment.
The PD has 1,100 followers on Twitter. The tweets are links to press releases on crime reports. Those are also featured on its Facebook page, which has 1,600 fans.
It's all the way to try to bring community members in to information that we share that can help them, help us.
But as of now, they're both ways to get information out, not in. That's why there's experimentation now with getting up two new blogs, one for Chief Louis Featheroff and one for the entire PD.
I've got this question about the police department. You know, I'm intimidated to call. I don't have the time to call, but I can sit on the computer and I can send a question in.
Communications consultant Spencer Critchley has worked with Salinas Police several times on community outreach.
This is something that's very effective, and it's really the trend in what's called Government 2.0, which is using these kinds of social media tools to allow people to interact more directly with their government.
Critchley says Salinas Police should move a step further with its Facebook if it really wants to build a relationship and trust with the people. He points to the Omaha Police Department's page as a prime example, which features personal messages and pictures.
It'll actually be a human being saying, "We had this tremendous birthday party for my kids at the station," and you start to feel like I'm getting to know these people. And this, of course, is how you build a sense of connection and build a trust over time.
Now, back here live, we're taking a look at the Detroit Police Department Facebook page, and here you see they have an automatic link to crime mapping and one to anonymous tip and a reminder to text information to them. So you see departments all across the United States using Facebook and other social media sites to their advantage. But Salinas Police Commander Tracy Molfino stresses that no matter how successful it is, nothing will replace good old-fashioned police work, and that includes the knocking door-to-door to get that personal face-to-face time. Dan.
All right. Thanks very much, Stephanie. Appreciate it. Another tool that Salinas police are using is something called crimereports.com. It is a mapping system that shows where and when different crimes take place. You can sign in with your Facebook login and connect with neighbors who also use that site. There's also a smartphone app with instant alerts.